I'm Alicia Menendez at MSNBC headquarters in New York. It's 4 o'clock on the East Coast. And this is the scene right now in Times Square, where on any other Saturday, the crossroads of the world is filled with crowds so thick you can barely see the sidewalks. The empty streets, a look at the new normal we now face as our country tries to stem the spread of COVID-19. Today, we learned President Trump has been tested for coronavirus.
I had my temperature taken coming into the room. I also took the test last night, yeah. And I decided I should, based on the press conference yesterday. People were asking, did I take the test? I don't know, whatever it takes, a day or 2 days, whatever it is, they send it to a lab.
The president said his temperature was, quote, totally normal. The administration adding new travel restrictions today. The United Kingdom and Ireland joining the list of European countries that are banned. Vice President Mike Pence said tomorrow we'll learn more about when the coronavirus website will be ready. That site is expected to direct people to the appropriate testing centers, including some drive-through sites like this one set up in the hard-hit area of New Rochelle, New York. 2,397 people across the country have coronavirus, and 51 people have died. Early this morning, the House passed an aid bill that guarantees free testing, 2 weeks of paid sick leave and paid family and medical leave, and boosts food security initiatives like food stamps. This is a story that is impacting every aspect of our lives. America is shutting down to save itself, as Politico put it. Perhaps most obvious, maybe your daily routine. 13 states have closed public schools. Many colleges have told students to stay home, finish the semester online. And companies from coast to coast are asking people to work remotely from home. Seemingly anywhere you want to go for fun is being shut down. Disney World, Universal theme parks, Broadway, and museums all announcing closures. St. Patrick's Day parades around the country canceled. The last 3 days were tough news for sports fans, with pro baseball, basketball, golf, hockey, and soccer all canceling or delaying games. March Madness is over, with the college basketball tournament called off. Buying groceries isn't even normal, as you may have seen for yourself or on social media. Store shelves are pretty bare. And while elected leaders placed a ban on large public gatherings, people lined up around the block for toilet paper and hand sanitizer. More drastic measures. The Denver Post reporting some police departments say their officers will not be responding to low-level crimes. New York, Miami, Baltimore are just some of the cities temporarily halting evictions. And government is waiving interest on student loans. Louisiana is the first state to delay its primary election set for April 4th. We're 3 days away from the next primaries. Election leaders in these four states say the votes will go on, but they're sanitizing machines. All of these changes have an enormous financial impact. On Thursday, stocks had their biggest daily drop in 33 years, with a rebound on Friday. Amid all this, the president refuses to take responsibility.
Dr. Fauci said earlier this week that the lag in testing was, in fact, a failing. Do you take responsibility for that?
Yeah, no, I don't take responsibility at all, because we were given a set of circumstances, and we were given rules, regulations, and specifications from a different time.